Miss Boosler, hi, Mike Cross.
Hi.
I'm sure I'm staying with you tonight. It's such an honor. My first time on TV. Oh. I'm so honored. You're a legend.
I'm a legend, just like Bigfoot and the Loch Ness Monster.
No, you're a pioneer.
I am a pioneer. Do you know that I also led Lewis and Clark across the Northwest Passage? But my name was Sacagawea then. I changed it for show business because it was too Jewish.
Sacagawea was Jewish?
Tonight on Access TV, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Mike Frost, Mark Riccadonna, Ali Siddiq, Aaron Burr. This week's host, Elayne Boosler. Gotham Comedy Live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Elayne Boosler.
Thank you so much. Welcome to Gotham, Gotham Comedy Live at Gotham Comedy Club in downtown Tomatoville. It's so great to be here. It's the hippest Thursday night in New York City. It's the place to be. Your hands are going to hurt so much by the end of this hour because we have the greatest show on earth tonight. I promise you we're going to be much funnier than the debate last night. Oh my God. Do you know I was actually supposed to host this last week? But I got stuck on Netflix, and I didn't know how to get off. I am not kidding. When I first got on Netflix, I did not know how to get off. And it traps you. It's like I'm watching, and then I went, oh, well, that was a good show. And then next episode starts in 11 seconds. 10, no, 9, no, 8, no, pee-pee, food, pee-pee, food. And it's on. Here we are. We just... Now I know how to get off. I go, no! And I just run away, and that's it. So I'm happy to be here, and we are more entertaining than the debate. And I have never seen... Did you watch a little bit of it? Yeah. Yeah. Well, you couldn't watch the whole 3 hours. I mean, that is cruel and unusual punishment. But wasn't it the most squabbling you've ever seen in your life? It was like being home for Thanksgiving. I want a turkey leg. You're too ugly to have a turkey leg. You ruined every turkey you ever managed. You're not getting this turkey leg. Well, I don't think women should be allowed to have turkey legs. Because they're abusing the turkey, and the turkey's a living thing. Shut up, you idiots. Oh, my God. Do you believe how Donald Trump talks about women? Said Carly Fiorina was too ugly to be elected. The reason he's against the Iran deal is he just doesn't think the leaders are handsome enough. This is the most wrong thing Donald Trump has ever said. You ready? The most wrong thing. 2 weeks ago, he said, women can't be leaders because they can't keep a secret. Dude, that's all we do. Entire existence is keeping secrets. That's what we do. You might be married to us for 50 years. You will never know us. I promise you, never. You could be falling asleep next to us after 20 years and you're thinking, good night, honey. Oh, she loves me. And you fall asleep and we're sitting there with our eyes open going, I could stab him in the chest. You wake up the next morning, good morning, honey. I could have killed you last night. We keep, you want to know if these are real? Well, I'm not telling. How old are you? None of your business. How much do you weigh? None of your business. You ever think of somebody else when you're in bed with him? I'm not telling you. You ever fake an orgasm? That's my business, not your business. You have a separate server in your house? What happened to 30,000 emails? You'll never hear it from me. Women keep secrets. What's the biggest selling women's deodorant? Secret. The biggest woman's clothing store in the mall. Anybody? Victoria's Secret. And we don't even know the secret, and that store's been open for 50 years. Well, actually, I think I do know the secret. I mean, they sell thongs, so the secret is you're spending $40 on a wedgie. How come there's no Victor's secret? Because men never buy new underwear. Ever. Well, not straight men. 40-year-old men show you their lucky underwear from college. Hey, look, I've had these since college. I believe you. They're all out of their minds, these people running for office. Trump says that Mexicans are sexual criminals. And so what happens? Chris Christie wants to put FedEx tracking on them? Who was the last guy who thought of putting numbers on human beings? Did put tracking numbers on human beings. I mean, FedEx isn't foolproof. My parents, when they were old, came to visit me in California, and they were too old to lift their luggage, so they sent it ahead, FedEx, and FedEx lost their luggage, and it took a whole week to find it. And in that whole week it took to find my parents' luggage, their luggage had raped 5 people. Need better leaders. People say to me, you must be so happy as a comedian if Trump gets elected, 4 years of comedy. No, it's way too important. I would much rather have good government and talk about my weight for 4 years. Which, by the way, I just did lose 24 pounds. Thank you very much. Nobody clapped when I gained 60. And that took a lot more work. It's the pizza. The pizza calls to me. The pizza. Yeah, I lost weight. You know what happens when how you get really heavy? You don't know it's happening. You just don't know. And then one day something happens. You go, I'm fat. So here's what happened to me, okay? I got in my car, and I had to tilt up my steering wheel. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? I had to let out my car. So it's kind of fun when you're older and you gain weight because it comes with a superpower. Yeah, you join the 50-50 club. Turn 50, gain 50. I'm invisible! Oh, I walk down the street, men don't see me, not even a glimmer in their eye. You know what? Sometimes I walk right up, I take their watches. The bigger you get, the more invisible you are. Honest, I was thinking, I was so heavy, I thought if I gain 10 more pounds, I'm gonna spy for the government in Afghanistan. I'm gonna mosey into the caves, get all the information, try the baklava. Mosey on out. Abdul, did you just see a plus-size woman in here? No, I did not. Where is my watch? Plus size. I went into the X's. They have 1X, 2X. I was 3X. I was so... three. There's only two things in America that are triple X. Porn and fat lady clothes. So I bought a disgusting DVD and a shirt. Now they're going a little smaller. They have OX. Oh, that makes you feel good. Pardon me, do you have this in OX? No, we don't. Maybe you should try the dress barn. Anybody in this dressing room? I was so sick of wearing animal prints. It's all animal prints when you're fat. Do they think we want to look like a herd of zebra broke off from the crowd? Animal, everyone in America has a gun. I'm gonna get shot jogging up Broadway. Ted Nugent's gonna kill me and put my head in his den. You guys are so good, and I am so excited to be here tonight. Gotham Comedy Club. We are coming back in a second with the best show on earth. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Mike Cross is taking the stage when we return. And stick around later tonight for Elayne Boosler when she hits the stage. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live, coming to you live from Gotham City and Gotham Comedy Club in Gotham City, which would be New York, for those of you who don't know. So I'm so excited. I love virgins, and this young gentleman coming up. Well, he is he's a TV virgin. He has never been on TV before. And you know, you dream about your first shot on television, and for him to have you as an audience, I'm so happy for him because you are so wonderful and smart, and you're already on his side, and you're gonna love him. How about a nice big virgin welcome for Mike Cross?
Thank you. Oh, thank you. That's very nice of you. Thank you, guys. So, I'm a married guy. Been married for, 3 years now. Don't bother applauding, you're fine. No, you're good. 3 years. And I can tell my wife and I, we're like slowly moving out of that honeymoon phase, you know? I know that. Because the other day I was in the living room, right, and I was eating. But I had to sneeze, so I held it in when I got my food because that's gross, you know? And you know when you hold it in, you make that noise, you do like the you know? I did that, and then 5 minutes passed by. Then all of a sudden, I hear my wife here in the room. She was like, hey, are you okay? That was like, yeah, why? She's like, oh, I thought I heard you choking. That was fucking 5 minutes ago. I should be dead right now. No air in my lungs in this point in time. It's like she heard me going, I was like, are you, you know what? I'm gonna wait this one out. Make sure he's good and dead. I thought that now that I'm married, like I wouldn't have to deal with rejection, you know? But I do. And it's not like dating, you know? Because when you go on a date and someone says no to having sex with you, you have the option of that date being over, you know? Like, I never know what to say when my wife says no. That's a very awkward moment. It's like, hey, honey, you look great tonight. Thought maybe we could fool around a little bit. And she's like, oh, no, not tonight. And I'm just like, cool, I guess I'll see you around the apartment. You gonna be here at the living room later? Maybe I'll see you around. This guy, thank you. I'm getting older, and I'm starting to realize like my parents are not the people who I thought they were, all right? Like I call up my dad, and he's Canadian, so he has a real thick Canadian accent, right? I call him up, and I'm like, hey, how's everything? And he's like, not good. I had a big scare the other day. I came home, I couldn't find the dog anywhere. I thought someone might have murdered the dog. But it ended up your mother just took her to the vet. I'm like, yeah, why would someone murder the dog? And he's like, well, you know, cause at work I've been threatening to kill some people. You're a hairdresser. How is that happening in your day? Like, oh, hey, you don't like your bangs? Well, maybe it'll look better at the bottom of the lake, huh? Ridiculous. My mom, though, oh, she's the worst. My mom, I go home to visit her, right? And she's like, hey, we have a rat in the basement. And I'm like, no problem. I'll just go buy some traps. And she was like, or we could make our own, all right? We'll get a bucket, all right? We'll get a ruler. We'll crack the ruler in half, put it across the bucket, put cheese in the middle of the ruler. That way, when the rat goes to get the cheese, it falls into the bucket of bleach. And I was like, yeah, you don't have to put bleach in that bucket. Like, who the fuck are you, the Saddam Hussein of killing rats? What the hell's wrong with you? I'm afraid to tell her we got raccoons in the garage in fear she'll want to waterboard them. You know what I mean? Like, hey, tell your friends, don't come around here no more, all right? But I come from a big family. I got 7 brothers and 1 sister. 9 of us. I know, that's a lot, yeah. One of my brothers is gay. He just got married. We're all very excited for him. Yeah, cool. Yeah, why not? Cool. Cool. Thank you. But growing up, my mom was always like, I think statistically, one more of you should be gay. Okay? And I got my money on you. And they all thought it was me. And don't judge me on this. I like you guys. Because when I was 12 years old, I had made a collage of Tom Cruise. I did that because I just love Tom Cruise, all right? And as soon as I made this thing, I got very scared. And I was like, no one can ever find this. Like, I'm never going to be able to explain why, you know? So I put it underneath my bed like you would a Playboy in hopes that no one would find it. And then one day, my mom sits me down out of nowhere, and she's like, Michael, if you're gay, the whole family will still love you. And I'm like, Mom, I'm not gay. I have no idea what you're talking about. And she was like, I found your Tom Cruise collage. And I had said the worst thing to say in this situation. And I was like, oh, which one did you find? I mean, it's not like I had 45 Tom Cruise collages, you know? But growing up, things are always funny to, like, my group of friends, but then outside that group, not very funny, all right? Before I tell you guys this story, we all know who Jeffrey Dahmer is, right? Yeah. Yeah, okay. So I was 15 years old, and I had just gotten my first wallet. And my buddies were like, hey, man, we dare you to keep a picture of Jeffrey Dahmer in your wallet. Then when someone brings them up, take it out. It will be hilarious. I kept that picture in my wallet for 10 years. 10, because go figure, people really aren't casually talking about Jeffrey Dahmer. He's not brought up at too many dinner parties, okay? Fast forward, I'm at a work event. Someone's talking. They're like, oh, yeah, I actually went to Ohio State. Someone else chimes in. And they're like, oh, hey, weird fact. So did Jeffrey Dahmer. And I was like, this is my moment. I've been waiting 10 years for this moment. This is gonna be hilarious. So I'm like, oh, excuse me. And I slowly reached for my wallet. I took out the picture. And I'm like, did you mean this, Jeffrey Dahmer? But it wasn't funny at all. Nobody laughed. The next day at work, my boss calls me to his office. He's like, Mike, look, I gotta fire you because I... people are scared. You have a picture of Jeffrey Dahmer in your wallet. And you think I would have learned my lesson. But I was like, oh, which one are you talking about? Thank you very much. My name's Mike Cross. You guys are great. Thank you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Mark Riccadonna is taking the stage when we return.
What a great act, and I think I've lost 2 more ounces while I was waiting, so. Nice shirt? Yeah, you like it? Thank you, thank you. 3D printer. Oh yeah, I print out all my clothes now. I can't wait for my next red carpet. Who are you wearing? Hewlett Packard? I am so excited to be bringing up this next gentleman. I have slept with him 30 nights in a row. Come on up, Mark. He is fabulous. We slept together for 30 nights in a row because, tell him why, because.
We were on tour with Armed Forces Entertainment over in the Middle East.
In the Middle East, we did.
30 nights.
30 nights. And the nights were even warmer than the days. It was 130 degrees in the daytime and 130 at night, but the sun wasn't out, so you felt a little cooler. We did the whole Middle East and Africa, and the hardest part of my life was having to follow this guy every night. He is such a great comedian and such a wonderful person. Really make him feel welcome back to the United States, Mark Riccadonna.
One time, Elayne Boosler. Elayne, I don't know if you remember when we were in Africa, I saw the coolest thing I ever seen in my life. We were in North Africa. I saw two turtles having sex. No, and they were going at it, too. I mean, they were just like... It got me really excited because it reminded me and my wife, you know? Wait, yeah, because, you know, the one on the bottom wasn't really into it. You know? Plus, I can't roll over once I'm on my back, so. We do get to travel as comics, and that's my favorite part. This summer, I was down south. I was down south, Atlanta, Georgia, and there was a group of guys out in a field. They were dressed up in Civil War outfits. They had weird hats, muskets, and they were reenacting battles from the Civil War. I saw that. I just wanted to run out and be like, wait, I'm from the future. I know how this shit ends. Follow me, there's air conditioning this way. But sometimes I like to go places, I like to see things in culture and steal it for myself. Like I was in Spain. Do you guys know Spain has a thing called a siesta? Huh, we need that here. Siestas are unbelievable. Every day at noon, you go home from work.
Take a nap.
Drink a bottle of wine. 4 hours later, if you feel like it, you go back to work. My whole life, I was called lazy. Here, I was just Spanish. I love my neighborhood. I live in a great neighborhood, and summer's winding down, so I'm going to miss my favorite activity in summer, and that is going to the park and watching junkies eat ice cream cones. They're so adorable. They usually steal them from the Mr. Softy truck, and they wander in the park. They're like... And they come too, and they realize they have ice cream. You literally watch somebody celebrate Christmas 5 times in a row. Not gain a calorie. That's why they're so skinny. They never finish their food. Yeah, I know. My wife told me not to tell that joke. She goes, you shouldn't make fun of addiction. It's an illness. And I was like, so's being fat, you know? She goes, watch this video, see if you still feel that way. She played a video on YouTube for me called Faces of Meth. Have you guys seen this video? Oh my God. They take arrest photos of meth addicts over like the period of 5 years. You see a normal human being slowly shrivel into a skeleton. I watched the video, my first thought was, maybe a little meth. They look good on day 3. So I am married. I love being married. I did the right thing. Engaged guy, write this down. When you go to get engaged or you talk, go to your mother-in-law first. Ask her first. Best move I ever made. My mother-in-law goes, Mark, whatever you do, don't buy a ring. Angie wants her great-grandmother's ring. It's a family heirloom from Sicily. Do not buy a ring. I was like, fuck yeah. I didn't have to buy a ring. Of course, the hard part was getting four guys to help dig up grandma. Angie took my name, too, when we got married. So her new name now is Angelina Marie Riccadonna. Loosely translated to meatball d'ago parmesan, right? I mean, that's Italian. So we're married. We have a dog. We have dog people in the crowd. Dog people? Yes. Oh, I wanted a man dog, right? A kind of dog I could take out to the park, do man stuff with. My wife goes, you can get a rescue dog. Well, that sounds good, right? So, yes. So we call up the, you know, we call up the HPCA. We go, we want to get a dog. They go, okay, here's what we're doing. We're putting you on a list. And what happens is when we find a dog, we call you. You get first dibs on them. Well, that sounds great. We get a phone call 15 minutes later. We found a dog. He was in the middle of the highway in the Bronx. You want him? I'm gonna ask a few questions. You found him on the highway. Is this a living dog? They're like, yeah, we found him. He was in the media. Nobody's claiming we're putting him up for adoption. I go, don't, I'll take him. Because I figured the Bronx, I was getting a pit bull. I was getting a Rottweiler. I got a Shih Tzu. Name Gizmo. But he's from the Bronx, so he got street cred, right? Yeah. He's a gangster Shih Tzu. I brought him home, first thing Gizmo did, he ran into the bathroom and he peed on the bottom of the toilet. My wife didn't even get mad. She's like, you don't even do that good. True, very true. So before I go, I'm excited to tell you, in November, Angie and I are having our second child. Thank you. Thank you. I gotta be honest with you guys, I feel really weird saying our second child, because I really didn't do that much. I mean, all I did is provide the magic beans. She built a baby, right? It's like going behind a chef with a pinch of salt and going, bam, our cake. The whole process of having a kid is very different than what I thought growing up, you know. They made us take classes. That was weird. We had to watch a film. It was called The Perfect Birth. And it opened with a yoga ball in the middle of a room, and this woman comes out. She leans on the yoga ball like this, completely naked. So I was interested. It's like, this is going to be a good movie. I've seen a few movies that start this way. I like where they go. Not this movie. It was a whole weird process, but by the end of it, it was worth it. And the day I saw the baby, I blew my mind. When I first met our first son, it was so amazing. And the doctor just looks at me and he goes, so you got a name picked out? I panicked. I said the first thing that came into my head, I said, yes, we're naming him after my father's father. We called him Grandpa. You guys have been so much fun. Enjoy your night. Thank you at home. Good night, everybody.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Ali Siddiq is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs right now.
Comedy Live. Everybody who's been on wants to come back on. That's how good you are. You really are. I mean, the director was saying to me, we never have a crowd this smart, this good, this smart, this good. So, yay for you. I do have one little sad announcement. If you happen to work in a Kentucky courthouse issuing marriage licenses, you're going to have to leave because my religion prevents me from making you laugh. People are in love. Let them get married. I saw a man on TV. He said, I am against homosexual sex. I said, well, let them get married. It'll stop. Guy said, every time a gay couple gets married, it diminishes the union between me and my wife. I wanted to say, sir, if what gay people did could trickle down and affect you, you would be a much better dresser. I mean, we can't have a country where Charles Manson's allowed to get married and gay people aren't. Manson got engaged last Christmas. Remember that in the paper? How did they meet? I guess online. Hello, my name's Charles. I live in a private gated community. We have such a great comic coming to the stage. I am sure you've seen him on Comedy Central. He's very happy to be here tonight because you are so excellent. Give it up for Ali Siddiq.
Hey, let me tell you something. Last time I've been in front of this many white people, they yelled, guilty! Let's see who in the building. Spanish people make some noise. Spanish people. Let me tell you something. If I wasn't black, I want to be Spanish. Spanish people do amazing things. They can stay with their family forever and nobody says nothing. Not like my little black ass family. Ever since I was 10 years old, I've been hearing this. You gotta get your ass out of here at 18. And I knew my mom was serious. I was 14, laying on the couch, and she walked by and said, time is ticking. Time is ticking. Wasn't black, I wanna be Spanish. Spanish men think they the sexiest men on the planet. That's why they keep their shirt buttoned down to their navel, being in the club doing all them sex ass dance. You ever seen them in the club with this shit right here? What the fuck is Raimondo doing? White people, black people, others, watch this. Spanish people, when the last time somebody broke in your house? Never. It's always somebody home in somebody's Spanish house. How you gonna break in with somebody looking at you? White people, make some noise. White people, just the white people. I'm just not getting used to y'all. I live in Houston. I live in the gated community in Houston. And my whole community is white. A bunch of white people and me. Black people don't judge me. I was looking for somewhere to stay. Didn't know. They tricked me because on the brochure, they had everybody on there smiling. I thought everybody lived over there. Let me tell you how I found out that it was all white people. Let me tell you what never happens. I'm from the projects. And when you move into the project, this is what never happens. Nobody comes and greets you when you move into the projects. Don't nobody say, hey, welcome to the projects, welcome to hell. Don't nobody do that. But in the gated community, they want to meet the new resident. I'm sitting in my house, minding my own business, doorbell rings. I open the door, 400 white people outside my door. I panic. I slam the door, boom. Call the police. They protesting. And I'm starting to get used to it. It's different. Let me tell you something. It's a saying that they say that the apple doesn't fall far from the tree, which is some bullshit. Because my apple has fell and rolled across the street. My son is the worst basketball player of all time. Let me tell you how bad he is. I'm the coach of the team that he played for, and I don't let him play. And I'm his father. It's a tournament that I've been winning for 3 years. Been winning this tournament for 3 years. I lost this year because I had to put my son in the game. Some of my players fouled out. I just sit the rest of my players out there. The referee calls a referee timeout. Say, coach, can I talk to you? I say, hey, what's up? What's happening? He said, you don't have enough players on the floor. I said, hey man, let them kids play. Let them play. He said, you need another player. I said, I don't have another player. He pointed at my son, talking about what's wrong with him. I said, man, I am trying to win. He said, you gotta put him in. I said, Trey, put your shoes on, you about to go in the game. That's how disinterested he is. He don't even got his fucking shoes on. So I sent him out there. Before I sent him out there, I called my players. I said, hey, look, Trey about to go in the game. Y'all go out there and just try to have some fun. Sent him in the game. See, everybody who coach things know that I gave up when you tell your team just try to have some fun. My son gets in the game and starts doing a drill that we do in practice. He in front of his player doing this shit. I call a timeout. Hey, timeout, timeout. Bring my players in. I went right to my son. I said, hey, man, what the fuck are you doing? He looked in my eyes. I'm trying to have some fun, coach. I couldn't even be mad at him because that's what I told him to do. He's horrible. My daughter, different story. She's a swimmer. She's a swimmer. She's a breaststroker. That's her thing. But she's fast in the fly. She's a flyer. And I've been tracking this little white girl named Sarah Brown because I know they're going to meet in the champs meet. I know they're going to meet. And my daughter, she's an arrogant little fly because she's been winning a lot of races, a lot of them. So she walks in because she's arrogant now. She don't even carry her shit in no more. She get out of the car and I'm walking in with all her shit. I'm like, hey, bitch, you can't hold a door? She walks past Sarah and sees Sarah and says some crazy shit. She say, hey, Sarah, I know we're going to race, but by the time you get finished, I'll be out the pool dry. I said, oh, shit. I'm right behind her. I said, yeah, dry, Sarah. You heard her, dry. So when we first started swimming, I used to think they was being racist towards my baby because she used to walk in and they would call her the black seal. They were like, oh, they go to the black seal. I'm like, hey, don't me call my baby no fucking black seal. My neighbor Ted told me, nah, man, that means she's really fast. I'd be out there rooting, go black seal, go black seal. So my daughter, the race happens, she loses the race. Yeah, come to me crying. Daddy, I lost the race. I say, hey, it's like that sometime, black seal. You was up against a great white. Who y'all think more confident, men or women? That's y'all. Y'all have this question. Women. I knew women was going to say that shit. Let me tell you something. Men are way more confident than women. Way more confident. Men don't give a shit about nothing. We don't care about being fat. We don't give a shit about being fat. We get right out the shower, butt naked, look right in the mirror, fat. We don't even know we fat until we bend over and tie our shoe and come up too fast and see them little lightning bugs. I'm like, I can't even catch one of these. Women care about being fat. That's why it's a lot of nice-looking women here, but I don't trust you, because I know that you put on a little contraption under your clothes to make your body look smooth. It's called Spanx, fellas, and they stuff fat in the shit. Back fat and extra titty fat, they stuff it in there, and you can't make a good decision in the club. Yeah, I'm going to take her home right there. Tell you something. Difference. Fellas, do not let women make you feel like you're sexually inadequate. Because women get together in little groups and have sex parties, and they buy shit that you can't compete with. I don't know what part of Africa you're from, but you can't compete with this. They got an engine on it. They'll start it up right in front of you, too. I'm like, what the fuck is that? Your competition. Y'all have been wonderful. Thank y'all so much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Aaron Berg is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
To Gotham Comedy Live at Gotham Comedy Nightclub in downtown Tomatoville. And what do you know about Spanx? I can't believe it. Ali, I don't wear Spanx. You can't wear Spanx unless you have family, because one person cannot get these things on. You need like at least 8 brothers and sisters to get into Spanx. It's very easy to lose weight in New York because everything's artisan here, which means tiny and overpriced. everything is artisan. Have you seen the cupcake store? Melissa something? I thought it was a jewelry store. I'm walking up Broadway, it's all glass shelves, women behind the counter in pearls and black dresses. I went, oh, I'll go and look at some jewelry. I walk in, I said, where's the jewelry? She said, it's a cupcake store. I said, this is a cupcake store? She said, yes. She whips out a black velvet cloth, puts it on the counter, puts a little cupcake on it. This big, $8, who's that gonna satisfy? I said, what is that? She said, it's carrot. I said, do you have anything in a 3-carat? Oh, you're in for such a big treat. Our next comedian is so wonderful. He actually has a new book out, which is called American Etiquette, which is so funny and so excellent. And he's just going to make you laugh so hard. He's the closer for a reason, because he's the best. Give a nice big welcome for Aaron Berg.
There you go. Cupcakes. Cupcakes. Oh, my God. I would not eat carbs at all. How are you, white privilege? This is exciting. Look at this. Right off your daddy's boat money into the fucking city. This is great. I can see your erection through those shorts. I appreciate that. Does this guy like it? Who's the top in this relationship? You are. You look a little more Latin. You look like you spice it up. You're like, I would bang you in a Chipotle bathroom. It's exciting. I've got the left side. Right side, way too liberal right now. Jump the fuck on board. These guys, Fox News. This, MSNBC right now.
It's exciting. How are you? Hi. Lovely black woman. Thank you. I love black women. Anyone here ever fuck black women? I know black guys don't. Let me tell you this. Black women are amazing. You talk shit, you're like, I'm gonna tear you apart, white boy. And then I get all excited. I'm like, this is gonna be wicked. And then you're like, watch my hair, my nails. Why are you on my Metro card? And then we're loosening up now, people. This is exciting. Don't check out on me, older woman. I know how you used to do back in the 80s. You fucked the Rolling Stones, am I right? Used to play a game called Whose Hole Is It Anyways? It was very random. I'm winning this guy over. Kai, you're gonna have to fill out complaint forms after. It's exciting. I love older women, very well seasoned, marinated down there. It's exciting. Losing some of you, the middle's on board, this black woman's repulsed. This is great. She's like, what the fuck? Why is Vin Diesel so angry? It's gonna be fun. What's your drug of choice, buddy? What do you like to do? You look like you fuck with some Molly, maybe do a bit of cocaine off a black man's penis. Not because it's racist, just because it's easier to see the cocaine, am I right? Crowd's coming alive now. I feel it. It took a while. They had to loosen up a bit because they weren't used to curse words. Exciting. I have a girlfriend, even though I look like I should be blowing you for a path card. This is the look. It's gay. It was tough in the 90s. Now it's like get him a glory hole in a French bulldog. Have a girlfriend. She's 34. That's a good age. I stop banging younger women. I find they don't come. They come out to comedy shows with their white boyfriends and sit there awkwardly. But older women come whether you want them to or not. Have you noticed that? I'll be like, I'm done. That's all I got. My girl's like, nah. Grab my nipple, motherfucker. Starts cranking one out to Metallica, like, darkness imprisoning me, all that I see, absolute horror. Give me your shoes. I'm like, you're white and from Delaware. I like this crowd right now. You guys are like, wow, this is like anal, but he's spitting on it first. Younger women masturbate way more differently. That's a weird phrase that I just said, but I'll stick by it. Like, you look peaceful. You look like you get in a bathtub, light some candles, turn on some Sarah McLachlan music. So I will remember you. I can't tell if I'm a squirter or not. It's all water in here. Is this your boyfriend behind you, the dude that looks so Jewish? That's amazing. Are you Jewish? Good for you. If not, you took the whole look very well.
Yeah, I will celebrate Rosh Hashanah and blow the shofar in a Latin woman's vagina.
I'm a Jew. I don't look it. I look like I eat Jews and mix them with creatine powder. Like, brrr, there's a gold watch in this blender. Do you have a Jewish girlfriend? Any girlfriend? No, you seem disappointed in that. Ginger chick, that's exciting, huh? Does her vagina come out and spout words of the devil at you? Like, mala, hala, hala, mala, hala. And do you have to be like, if I was a rich man? This is fun. That is a good laugh. You're confused. You're like, this karaoke's dirty. Why is the karaoke cursing? The rock is shorter than I thought. Good thing about being Jewish, the fucking cock, right? Mine's huge, 8 inches. I measure from the small of my back, but... that's where you measure from, am I right? No, not gay people, they measure by their throats, but... Thank you, don't know if you're gay, but everyone thinks you are. If I didn't have a microphone, this would be hate speech, you know that, right? And everyone here is like, this is amazing. He says what we all want to. Great, Jewish. Best thing, circumcised, right? Are you cut? No. You got that fucking dirty artisanal cheese platter you call a cock, right? Take your pants down. What the fuck smells like gorgonzola? That's our love. It's horrible. Aren't you glad you're cut? Yeah. You? You don't like, yeah, you like pulling up the cape and letting the bulls loose, am I right? The running of the bulls in Pamplona. And I love the way you look so Swedish, too. Like, you look like you would be like, I am entering you now, and it will be awkward, and I will prolapse your anus. That's exciting. But you're gay, but you look, like, so white. What do you jack off to? Like, Donald Trump bondage videos or something? I'm losing them a little bit. I'm aware of it. This is great to be here. I moved here from Canada originally to live my dream, which was to perform in front of 86 people. And... You have surpassed my expectations so far. It's great. I love living here. I live in Queens. I lived in Harlem for a while because I love the smell of cocoa butter. And people got that. Racists got it. Latin chicks confused. Jew guys like, I own property up there. It's a very... Don't make fun. You'll drop the value. That's great. Have you been with a black dude before? It's amazing, right? Well, that's what I heard. You would know, but it's like... But it hurts, right? Because they are fucking emotionally unavailable. And you say, I watch Fox News. That's where I get most of my education from. Got to find something strong to close on, and then we'll get the fuck out of here. It's been very exciting. Been very exciting. I love this. You're gonna go home and fuck tonight under the scornful eye of Kim Davis, and she's a beast, am I right? Would you eat her out for $1 million and a path card? No, never. I had a horrible job back in Canada. I worked as a stripper once, as you can tell by my fantastic physique. Thank you. And it was weird. I just did it for a summer, and then 4 years after that. And it's so different when we go to a strip club than when women go. We go, there's rules. Like a bouncer comes over, like, sit down, drink your drink, don't touch the girls, don't look Macaulay Culkin in the eye. And women go, it's Vegas with penises. There's fireworks and an MC, like, welcome to Cockfest 2015. I see a lot of lawbreakers. And women in here, you're very well behaved right now. You get these girls in a room with 4 naked men they've never seen before and a firefighter hat and some Bon Jovi music. And say, not cheating if I just rub it on my face. Guys, you've been amazing. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Thank you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Elayne Boosler is taking the stage when we return.
Incredibly awesome, and I needed this so much because I have been so tense. The way I exercise is I walk around Manhattan. And it used to be a pleasure, but it is so stressful now because you used to have walk, don't walk, and you knew what to do. But now it counts down, 20, 19, 18, and I don't know how much time I need. And, like, every street corner is a hand to blackjack, you know? It's like, oh, I got 18. What do you want to do? I think I'll stay. No idea. I do fly out tomorrow, and of course I'll be taking my shoes off, which I've been doing for 14 years. I don't know why we're taking off our shoes. What woman is gonna blow up her shoes? Prada, hello. This is how they should do security. Prada, go. Prada, go. Jimmy Choo, go. Louboutin, go. Pay less, step out, sir. Step out. Yeah, they always pull me out. It's always me and three 90-year-old grandmothers with Garfield on their sweatshirt, spread-eagled, crying their eyes out, and two guys on camels with sabers in their teeth are trotting onto the plane. Talking into their shoulder, we are on, we made it. They got the plus-size women. Wait, where is my watch? You guys are the best. You're so awesome. Thank you so much. You're so good. Let's bring our comics back up here. Here we are. Yeah. You guys. The best. How about a nice big hand again for Mike Frost, Mark Riccadonna, Ali Siddiq,